Hello, beautiful people. Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for coming back to see me. If you're new, I'm Jan, and today we're going to be doing a hair tutorial. Had some people ask about how I style my hair. I actually did just get it cut a few days ago. I have the best hairdresser in the entire world, and I'll leave her information down below. Her name is Shannon. She works at Bella Salon and Spa. If you are in the Philadelphia, Chester County, Exton-ish, Chester Springs, I believe is the actual location, she's amazing. She's an amazing person and she's amazing with hair. So half of all of this goes to her. So before we get started, I'm going to tell you guys what I do. Obviously, I just washed my hair, kind of just threw on a quick little makeup here. I wanted to show you guys what I use in the shower. So I've been using this Amika Bust Your Brass Cool Blonde Shampoo. This is a shampoo that is actually purple in color. Not sure if you can see that. This definitely isn't my favorite purple shampoo, but this is the one that I'm currently using. You really have to make sure that you rinse your hair really, really well when you use this, because if not, it does leave like a little bit of a residue in your hair. My conditioner that I use, I should preface this by saying I really only wash my hair like twice a week. Because it is colored, I try not to wash it all that often. So I actually use this L'Oreal Total Repair 5 Damage Erasing Balm. I've been using this for like 5 years now. You can tell that it's well loved, pretty much almost out of this one. But I use this every time I wash my hair, and I've always loved this. I love the way that it smells, I love the way that it feels, and I usually only use it on the very ends of my hair, and then I'll run whatever's left in my palms just all over my hair, and I find that this is really, really nice to condition your hair. So I then use a Turby Twist. I find that these really help kind of get the water out of your hair. This is a purple one. You can see here, what you do is you flip your head over like this, wrap your hair in it, twist it, come back here, and there's this little thing and it attaches here. So it's really small. You're able to, you know, kind of, you can do your makeup, you can do, you know, whatever you need to do while your hair is drying, and this is a microfiber towel, so it's really handy. So this is my hair out of the shower. I'm gonna comb it. My favorite comb is the Tangle Teaser. This is full of dry shampoo. I actually have two of these, and I'm just detangling my hair. So I'll be honest with you guys, I don't really use a heat protectant. That's probably really bad, but I have never found one that I absolutely love. If you guys know of a good hair protectant, let me know. This is the Kenra Texture Wax Texture Defining Mousse. I'm gonna be putting a little bit of this into my hair today. I'm just gonna rub that into my hair. All right, and as you can see, my hair does have a little bit of like wave to it. It's not completely straight. So next up, we're gonna blow dry the hair. This is an oldie but a goodie, Conair. I have the tip on here to blow dry the hair. I'm gonna take this brush. This is a Revlon round brush, and I'm gonna be using this to blow dry my hair. And I'm not gonna make you guys listen to this, but basically what I'm gonna do is blow dry my hair like this. And I usually only do it to the front, and then I'll just kind of blow dry the back. Now that you look like a crazy person, I just brush through my hair. So after you're done blow drying your hair, you're just gonna wanna brush through it. And then up next, we're gonna go in with a straightener. My hair kind of naturally parts itself off to the side. You can part your hair down the center. You can do however you would like. I do have some post-styling products that I want to use in my hair. So this is the Way Memory Mist. This is going to help your hair kind of stay. It's like a light hold hairspray pretty much, but it's going to help your hair kind of stay in place. All right, so then what I usually do is I'll straighten my hair. I'm going to go through and just straighten it. Mostly what I'm trying to do here is get the end straight so I can go in and curl the rest of my hair. So the last and final step before we curl the hair is we're gonna add some dry shampoo paste. I think I might have used a little too much of that mousse. Hair looks a little sticky. Hoping that this fixes the problem. So this is the Badlands Dry Shampoo Paste by R&Co. Looks like this. I take a little bit on my finger, about this much. Work it through my hands, and then I'm going to apply it in my hair. As you can see, that gives you some volume. All right, we're gonna brush this out. If you're looking for some hold, look no further. So the very final step is to curl your hair, and I have two more products to show you guys after that, and then we're all done. So I actually really like this Remington curler. This is an oval curler, so you'll see it's not a complete barrel. It's actually oval. You have to be careful because if you try to do it, it might have a kink. But so I should probably tell you guys how I'm doing this. So I'm lifting my opposite hand over my head, taking a little section, about this big, having the curler in my hand, over my head, wrapping it backwards away from the face. I find that this is the most flattering for my face. So as you can see, it's creating little curls, and I am leaving the ends out of the wand. I don't want to curl the ends because I want them to be straight. And sometimes I'll even do something like this where I'll roll it, especially this front piece because I don't want it to be too curled. That piece had like a weird kink in it, so we're just gonna roll that. So after you're done curling your hair, basically you just want to let it cool off just a little bit. But then what we're going to do is we're going to go in with a thickening spray or a texture spray. This is by IGK. This is called Beach Club. This smells so good. So I kind of just shake my hair out. Loosen up everything that we did. And I'm going to spray this up into the hair to give it some texture. This is the Not Your Mother's After Curfew Unscented Hairspray. I also always use dry shampoo daily. If I'm not using the Not Your Mother's Unscented Dry Shampoo, I'm using the Lush shampoo. The No Drought Dry Shampoo is my absolute favorite. It's literally in a bottle and it's like a dry, almost like a baby powder that will change your life. So if you have blonde hair, if you have dark hair, it will leave a white cast, so you have to be aware of that. But if you have blonde hair, I think that you'll really, really like that one. This will actually last in my hair a few days, so I won't have to redo it. And honestly, like, the third day is the best day, where it's just really messy, a lot of dry shampoo, really big. I like big hair. And it is possible to achieve thick looking hair when you don't have thick hair, pretty thin hair. But my hairdresser tells me I have a lot of thin hair. So this is it. This is the last of the hair things that I have to show you guys. I hope you guys like this. PC hair. And yeah, guys, that is it. I will link everything down below that I used in this tutorial. If you guys want to see any more hair tutorials, definitely give this video a like. Subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.